This week, we're talking about market concentration, how huge corporations control entire sectors of our economy without having to compete, and why it matters to you. Yes, you. You know, back in the old days, if two or three companies controlled an entire industry, we understood that this would make it hard for small businesses to break into the market. It would make it difficult on competition and even consumer choice. We wrote antitrust laws that restricted corporations for cornering the market and trying to engage in anti-competitive behavior, using their size to keep out the competition, stop choice, and limit people's opportunity. These antitrust laws are still on the books and are among the strongest antitrust and anti-monopoly laws in the world. Then, in the early 1980s, our government decided to stop enforcing anti-monopoly laws. From that point forward, we saw mergers that consolidated entire industries into the hands of a few. As a result, our economy is ruled by monopoly power. There is only a handful of big banks that control our entire financial sector. Our beverage industry is controlled by a few massive corporations. And our telecom industry is ruled by just four or five companies. And companies like Walmart and Google and Amazon have such a tight grip on the marketplace that they essentially do not have to compete. This week, I'm talking to Barry Lynn, author of the book Cornered, and one of the foremost experts on monopoly power in this country. Barry doesn't keep it all high in the sky. Barry breaks it down so everybody can understand why having these big monopolies in all these industries across the entire economy is a bad thing and really needs change. He wants you to know about it. Barry, why don't you introduce yourself?
I'm Barry Lynn, and I direct the Open Markets Institute, which is a new organization because recently the Open Markets Program was part of the New America Foundation. But we got kicked out for taking on Google.
Well, you know, I read your book, Cornered. It's a great book. I recommend it. But let me just ask you this. You know, what was your main point in Cornered? And you know, what is antitrust? What is anti-monopoly legislation? And, you know, why do we have it?
Yeah, so the main point that I was making in Cornered is that we have a really, really big monopoly problem in America today. You know, as you said, you know, this is probably the worst concentration we have ever seen in the United States. It's worse than the Gilded Age.
And the Gilded Age was back in the 1890s or so?
1890s, up through the first decade of the 20th century, you know, a little more than 100 years ago. This is the time of the plutocrats. And, you know, the plutocrats pretty much ran the country back then.
They're back.
They are sure back. And these guys got tools that the last group of plutocrats did not have.
I wish they had.
Oh, yeah. These guys have spy devices. They have the ability to track what you're doing and see where you're going. And this is something that no plutocrat back in the old days ever had.
But, you know, but at that time, there also was a response to the market concentration. You had a president like Theodore Roosevelt. You had the progressive movement, which made anti-monopoly a cornerstone of their work. Do you see any movement today sort of pushing back against this market concentration that we see so prevalent?
Yes. I mean, we see the movement sort of breaking out right now. It's been people were really quiet for a long time. People just didn't see the problem. But just in the last year, we've seen all kinds of movement here in Washington, but also across the United States. It's, you know, for the first time, I've been doing this for a long time. I've been studying concentration for 20 years and the ills of concentration. And, you know, now over the last year, for the first time, I see real movement.
So here are two related questions. How bad is it? And what are the ills of concentration?
Well, I'll do the second one first, and it's like we've been taught for the last generation to say, oh, well, concentration is bad for me as a consumer. It means higher prices. It means less choice. And that's true. It does mean higher prices. It means less choice. But the real fundamental ills of concentration of power, concentration of control, is a loss of liberty. It's the loss of our ability to, say, get a new job when I wanted to get a new job. Mm-hmm. It, you know, I become captured by my employer. What it also means is the subversion of our democracy. When a few people control all of the wealth, and when they control the main levers of power in our economy, they control our country. We do not have a democracy if we allow this kind of concentration of power. Liberty, democracy, that is what is now under threat.
Could you tease that out a little bit? I mean, like, so how do the plutocrats, I'm talking about the big concentrated business leaders, how do they manipulate our democracy?
Well, they manipulate our democracy through the investment of money. They manipulate, you know, in campaigns. They
campaign donation.
That's right, campaign donations and just
lobbying
and you know, just choosing which candidates get to run. You know, just but also just, you know, basically setting the table in Washington, determining what the agenda is going to be. You know, what what are we going to talk about and what are we not going to talk about? This is actually the, you know, with us. I mean, we were. At New America, when Open Markets was there, we were trying to shine a light on the ways that Google and other platform monopolies, we're not only an anti-Google shop, we're an anti-monopoly shop. So we were looking at how a number of companies are misusing their power, and we got booted. And that's one of the ways that these corporations, these powers, subvert our democracy. It becomes impossible for us to actually have open debate.
So they set the terms of conversation. I can tell you this, Barry, you know, as a member of Congress, so much of what gets discussed around here is driven by this or that think tank, quite frankly. I mean, and if the think tanks are like, hey, we don't talk about monopoly, we don't use the M word, then that topic is less likely to be on the lips of people around here.
No, that's absolutely right. And we've been tracking this for a long time, and we really were, for a very long time, the only people that used the M word.
Monopoly.
Yes.
I said it.
And but this year, you know, we now have other groups that are working with us. We have friends at CAP. We have friends
Center
at Roosevelt.
Center for American
yeah,
Progress.
The Roosevelt Institute. We have friends over even in Brookings now.
All right.
And so this, we have friends on the Republican side who are starting to understand that this isn't a game anymore. This isn't a matter of just like enriching my friends. This is what we're playing for now in this country is the preservation of our democracy and our most fundamental liberties.
Well, you got some good friends on the Dem side. I mean, you got Elizabeth Warren. Well, she's been very vocal on this issue. And Hank Johnson over here has been great. Ro Khanna has been on this issue. And even little old me has been talking about this issue a little bit. So do you sense that there are more members of Congress willing to talk up on this issue of cartels, monopoly, market concentration?
No, absolutely. The change from, say, 2 years ago is fantastic. And the first step, and I can't say that we are on the verge of actually having a fix here to this problem, but the first step to fixing the problem is seeing the problem, and the second step is speaking about the problem. And we now have a bunch of brave leaders in Congress, in the Senate, who are talking about this. And that's what helps the American people understand that we have a problem and that we can fix it.